Boy, long before I was sniffing my pipes, I was smelling cigars because there's hardly anything in the universe that smells nice as cigars. Well, I can think of one other thing, but I won't talk about that here. Anyway, today, the long-awaited video of how to light a cigar. Now, I want to say something before I actually make this video and do what I'm going to do here. There's lots of ways of doing cigars and pipes and lighting them and smoking them, and there's no real one right way. I'm going to show you my way and give you my ideas on the subject. I've been smoking cigars since I was 8 years old, and I'm 52 now, so that's a long damn time. Not every day, of course, once in a while. And I've done a lot of reading on cigar smoking and how to cut a cigar, how to light a cigar, and I'll give you what I know. If you want to do it differently, that is okay. I'm not saying anybody else is wrong. This is just my way. I have reasons why I do it the way I do it. But anyway, first off, what to light with. I don't recommend you use these little Bic lighters. I used to, and I've done it many times and done it for years. I hear that the fluid inside these lighters isn't really that clean a fluid, that pure a fluid. You can use matches, which I find kind of a pain in the butt, frankly, so I don't use matches with cigars. You don't really have to use matches. What I did is I went out and bought myself a nice little I Am Corona lighter. This isn't an old boy. An old boy is a pipe lighter. This is I don't know what it is, but I love the classic look of the thing. And I just happened to get a really good deal on this online, actually. I just kind of lucked out on eBay one day. Someone put this some dealer put this on for a very reasonable price. So this is what I use. And I put very clean, high quality fuel in this thing. Again, if you're going to put really low quality fuel in a nice lighter, then you might as well use a Bic lighter. Okay? So matches or a nice lighter with high quality fuel is good. All right. This cigar has been pre-cut. Unfortunately, some of the wrapper is also cracking, so I don't know how well it's going to smoke, but we'll try it. The first thing is, I've seen folks go and lick the entire cigar and get it all wet on the outside. I don't think that's necessary. In fact, I will wet the end a little bit when I cut a cigar, but I don't like getting my cigar wet at all. I kind of keep it dry as possible on the end like that, so the cigar doesn't get all gnatchy looking and disgusting. As far as the light goes, get up where you can see it. Okay. The first step is hold your cigar at a bit of an angle and do not let the flame touch the cigar. Hold the cigar so it's a little bit of an angle and just toast the cigar. Now, I don't know if you can see this or not, but even though that flame that's about an inch and a half or so away from the cigar, inch away, is still toasting the edge. And you want to just toast the edge, okay? You want to just toast the very edge. Can you see what's already happening there? You're not trying to light the middle part here. Don't worry about that. That'll take care of itself, okay? You want to toast just the corner there, just the little edge there. See what I'm doing right there? Just the edge. And you want to move your cigar. See, it's trying to actually light itself on fire already. Around, toasting the edge like that a little bit. That's what you want to do. You do not want to let the flame actually touch your cigar. You don't want to do that. The point of this light, the whole thing here, oops, whole point of the light here is to gently light the cigar. Dunhill wrote a book on pipe smoking called The Gentle Art of Pipe Smoking, which I haven't read, by the way. And that smells good. Damn, this is going to be a good cigar. Now, I subscribe to that idea, the gentle art of pipe smoking and the gentle art of cigar smoking. Again, you can do what you want. I've seen people light their cigars with acetylene torches. But I believe tobacco should be handled very gently when it comes to lighting, and other ways too. And the same with packing the pipe. You should handle it very gently. Take it easy on it. Treat a cigar or pipe tobacco like you would a lady, Be very gentle with them, very careful. There are some girls like to be tied up and spanked, but I guarantee you no cigar, no pipe tobacco wants to be tied up and spanked. So be very gentle. All right? So again, we're gonna go just gonna toast here. And again, don't have the flame all over the cigar. You don't want to overheat the cigar. We're just gonna toast the outer edge. You want to do this right, and what will happen is then you can get a cigar that's going to smoke properly and it's going to smoke evenly, because that's what you want. See, even though the flame is an inch and a half away from that cigar, it's still catching nicely on fire. You don't need to, you don't need to get the flame all over the cigar and go crazy with it. Now, once you've done that, gently blow out the cigar. So if there's any kind of, chemicals are in there that's been created by the lighting or from the butane or whatever, you kind of blow them out of your cigar a bit. Just slightly gently. Now, if you can see how even though that flame wasn't really very close to the cigar, it's already burned a nice little ring around that cigar. It's got to kind of halfway going. You want your cigar to burn evenly and consistently. And how you light the cigar, this little ring you make in the beginning will have a lot to do with that. So I'm just gonna, just for the fun of it, I see a little few little spots which could be a little better. Okay. And keep it at an angle because you're not trying to light the middle of the cigar. Now, once you've gotten here, now you're ready to actually do the actual light. Don't blow your lighter out. Again. You don't need. You don't need to totally, incinerate the end of your cigar. You don't need to do that. It's not necessary. And you don't need to worry about lighting the inner part of the cigar. If you light the outer ring, like I've done here, the inner part will burn. You don't want your cigar to tunnel, which is have the inside lit and the outside not. So you light the outer ring. That's all you worry about. The rest of the cigar will burn on its own and will hopefully burn correctly. See how easy that was? You see guys online, and no offense to those guys, I love you like brothers guys, all you pipe smokers and cigar smokers, but they'll take a flame and just go, they'll just, the cigar. It's not necessary. It's just not necessary. When you do that to a cigar, you can end up burning too much inside and all around, and it can make a cigar a little tunnel that won't burn correctly, and it can put some nasty flavors in the cigar you're not going to want. You want to taste the tobacco, not a bunch of carbon burned yuck. All right, gentlemen, that's it. Gentlemen, ladies, hope that helped a little bit. What a cigar. 8 minutes to go, 8 minutes. All right, guys. That's too long a video anyway, so that's it for this little video.